Now, President Marcos formally swears in disbarred lawyer Larry Gadon as his new advisor on poverty alleviation. Gadon thanked the president for appointing him as anti-poverty czar. Last month, the Supreme Court unanimously disbarred Gadon over abusive and misogynistic remarks he made to a journalist. Gadon had shrugged off his disbarment, saying the word secretary is sweeter than attorney. Philippine Interior Secretary Benher Abalo sees no reason to postpone the village and youth council polls in Negros Oriental. In an interview with Teleradio Serbisyo, Abalo says the province has been relatively peaceful since the killing of Governor Ruel Degamo in March. He advises local officials to instead focus on the province's economic recovery. Degamo's widow, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, and eight other local executives had called for the postponement of the elections, citing security reasons. The Philippine Election Commission will craft a decision on the proposal when the election period begins on August 28. Alleged drug trafficker Jad Dera now in a Muntinlupa jail after he was caught going in and out of the National Bureau of Investigation's detention facility multiple times. Justice Secretary Rimulya also says they are still investigating the extent of Dera's influence within the NBI, but he believes Dera might have influenced some NBI probes. Dera and six NBI security personnel are facing raps over his unauthorized trips. Last month, he was seen dining out in a hotel in Makati.
Yung nangyari kay Dera, isang malaking mabuting at nangyari yan. Kasi may natuklasan kami ng mga gawain ni Dera sa loob na kung saan na-implementyahan niya mga ibang investigasyon ng mga taong nakakulong doon sa loob ng NBI Detention Center kasi siya ang nagsisilbing nagmimistulang mayor ng mga nakakulong doon. Marahil may mga na-implementyahan na pangyayari sa loob na amin pang pinag-aaralan.
The Philippine National Police denies allegations they did not coordinate with the Justice Department during the Las Piñas Pogo raid. PNP spokesperson Jean Fajardo told ANC the PNP anti-cybercrime group coordinated with the Justice Department. She also debunked Justice Secretary Rimulya's claims the raid was baseless and lacking sufficient evidence.
On the part of PNP anti-cybercrime group, according to them, they have done the necessary coordination with Interagency Council Against Trafficking. And in fact, prosecutors were present during the initial stages of the implementation of search warrant. And this Interagency Council Against Trafficking, the head of that council is the Department of Justice. There were complainants actually that who came forward and provided information. That were the basis why the PNP ACG applied for search warrant. The mere fact that these search warrants were issued by the concerned regional trial court would only prove that there was indeed a probable cause for the case of human trafficking.
Police Chief Benjamin Acorda Jr. meanwhile vowed to crack down on fugitives manning POGO hubs in the country. Acorda called the trend alarming.
Well, yun nga, that is the one of the observation or one of the reports na nakita na received natin coming from our operating units wherein there were some fugitives na nakuha in this POGO operation. And yung sinasabi mo kung talagang ito ang practice or modus operandi na ginagamit ng itong mga fugitives na to hide in this kind of hub, there is a possibility. We are intensifying our efforts as far as yung mga illegal operations of this kind of business.
The Philippine Justice Department flags a human trafficking raid in Las Piñas City last month. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya called out the PNP anti-cybercrime group for not coordinating with the DOJ's Interagency Council Against Trafficking. Rimulya also claimed the PNP pushed through with the raid despite lack of evidence. Five Chinese suspects have been released for further preliminary investigation. Police rescued some 2,000 alleged trafficking victims at a Las Piñas POGO facility during the June 26 raid.
May pag-uusap na kasi ang DOJ at saka yung anti-cybercrime group ng PNP na bago kumilos, ay mag-case build-up muna para pag tayo ay nag-raid at tayo ay manghuli, ang lahat ng ating huhulihin ay pihadong may ebidensya laban sa kanila. Hindi po ito naging nasunod. Tumuloy po sila at ngayon, marami hong nakabinbin na hindi ma-file na kaso sapagkat wala namang ebidensya na kompleto. Iyan sa isa sa mga problema. Kaya mag-uusap kami muli ng anti-cybercrime group. Walang specific acts, walang specific grounds para hulihin ng tao, walang specific complainants ng maraming tao, basta raid lang, raid. Ganun. Pumasok lang sila para nangingisda. Ay na sinasabi na namin dati pa. Noong nangyari sa Pampanga, nag-usap kami ng staff, sinabi na namin, mag-case build-up tayo bago tayo pumasok sa ganyan. Kasi kami ang bibigyan nyo ng responsibilidad. Tsaka hindi kami papayag na maglagay o magtanim ng ebidensya kahit kanino.